Western Michigan lines up to kick this one off, and we're just about set to get underway. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Tackled at the 24-yard line.
Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
From their own 24-yard line, second down.
Mike 51. Dog 4. Blue 4. Blue 4.
They hand it off again, and he's tackled at the 27. Fires out to his wideout. Fourth down upcoming as they go three and out. It looks like they're going to go after this punt. Booming kick. Tackle made at the 29-yard line. The Broncos, in talking with them this week, Kirk, it's just interesting their perspective on this kid, how good he is, and how much they can lean on him.
Yeah, you and I had a chance to visit with not only the coaches, but the player himself, and I got a real good vibe walking out of those meetings and thinking that he's going to have a huge game. The coaches seem confident in being able to get him the football in different areas on the field. This kid has a look in his eye that I haven't seen in a long time where he just wants to have a chance to have an impact on the game and on the outcome, and I'll be shocked if they can slow him down.
First and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line.
40's mine. 40's the mic.
Set. Green 88. Green 88.
And down he goes at about the 47-yard line.
Brings him down at the 47-yard line. That brings up second and 1.
Mike 40. Mike 40.
The sub package in there defensively in this 5-wide receiver set. Caught by the sophomore. Tackle made to the 38-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Ready, waiting, up.
Quick strike to the receiver, and they make the stop at the 32-yard line.
Number 9 makes the tackle at the 32-yard line.
From the 32-yard line, second down.
Green 9.
Under heavy pressure. And he tackles him hard at the 31. Quarterback picked up a yard at best there on the scramble. No, he dropped it.
The quarterback threw it right into the hands of the safety. I can't believe he dropped it.
Fourth down. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. Western Michigan is looking to go up by 3. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he splits the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Broncos are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Cat.
fake and looking to run. And they get the sack.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 23-yard line. It's going the other way. The 10. Touchdown, Western Michigan. So they'll review this to see if the receiver had control of the ball. But I got to tell you, I think it looked like the ball bounced into his hands. So the officials are going to take a look at some of the replay angles.
And what they're looking for is whether or not the ball touched the ground before he had possession.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So they review it, but there's just not enough evidence to overturn this one. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Broncos are looking downright scary on defense so far, Herbie.
They are flying around as a group right now, completely aware of what this offense is trying to do and dismantling them every single time on every single play.
Let's see how the defense responds now, coming off that big play just a moment ago.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful, because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off of mistakes. Did somebody miss an assignment there? I mean, this kid came in untouched. I don't know if it's the wide receiver or maybe the tight end. Somebody's got to be able to block that corner. He's going to make plays all day.
We've got a second and 14. Ball on their own 21.
Red, two,
quick out to his receiver. And they push him out around the 29-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Gets it out quickly. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 42-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 42. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. And he's taken down around the 49-yard line. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Brought down at the 47. First down pick up by the tailback.
You can see how comfortable this guy is with that football in his arms.
Up the middle for a nice game. We've got a second and five. Ball on the 42-yard line.
Mike 51.
Red 2.
Kill, kill, kill. Yellow.
And a quick throw. He's hit and taken down. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five wide set. He comes in with his dive package. He's tackled right away. First and 10. Ball on the 19-yard line. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds. That's it for one, and we might have the upset of the week on our hands. 10-0, Western Michigan. we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. Everybody bunched up tight defensively. Tackle just outside the goal line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard.
That brings us. Here's the 11th play of the drive. Touchdown, MSU. And so they punch it in on the ground. Kirk Herbstreit,
great job up front by the offensive line. They get a good, strong push that allowed the runner to get it in there for the touchdown.
Here's the extra point to get within a field goal. And he hits the PAT. It was an 11-play, 74-yard drive. They put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drop. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Fires out to his receiver. He's taken down around the 36-yard line.
That's a gain of 11 on the play.
From their own 36-yard line, first down. Western Michigan is up a field goal.
Ready, red, 68, red, 68.
And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
Just another weapon for this offense. He's got good hands, and he's tough to bring down. He showed right there that he can make something big happen.
They go with a run, and he's brought down in the backfield.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sideline, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
Out of bounds, around the 48-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. Here's the halfback on the screen. The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. And this one is a beauty. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. He's out to the 30. They'll bring him down right around the 32-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 32. Nice run there. And he hits him hard at the 49-yard line. We've got a first and 10. All on the 49. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the 5-wide set. Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's tackled at the 37.
Red, two, go. 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 Go.
makes his way to about the 22. It's first and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line. It out to about the 21-yard line, and he gets a yard on the run.
Great play by the senior linebacker to step up in traffic and make that tackle. Defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Red 2, go!
Fires quickly, and he's got his man, and he's hit before he can go anywhere. They're going to try a long field goal here. Michigan State can tie it up here with this kick. Kick is up. It's got the distance. And he just drilled it from long range. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both offenses have played it pretty close to the best so far in this one.
Yeah, because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up and take a few chances.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Quick pass, and he's tackled at the 35-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. The Broncos are going to call their second timeout. From their own 40-yard line. Second down.
Green 95.
Quick pass, and he's right there to knock it away. Well defended that time.
You're right. Great job here by the defender playing the ball, keeping his balance, and getting in the way of that pass.
There's a strike complete, and down he goes at around the 48-yard line.
98 Weasel! 98 Weasel! Ready! First down.
He sails it long.
Almost a big play. He patrols the deep part of the field like a center fielder, though he didn't make the catch like one.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Ready. Green 88. Green 88.
Tries to thread the needle, and it's not going to work.
That was perfect coverage against a pretty good route. He was all over that pass.
From their own 42-yard line, it's first down. They come out on an empty backfield. Makes the catch, and look out. And they make the stop at the 48-yard line.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Number 13, the intended receiver.
From the 48-yard line, second down. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. And it's intercepted. And he tackles him hard at the four. We played a half of football. This one's all even at 10.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Defense has been dominant in this game. Yards very hard to come by. But David, as we get deeper and deeper into this game, the natural assumption is that the pressure goes to the offense to do something.
No.
How much pressure is on the defense not to make that catastrophic mistake?
Well, that's the conundrum you get in. I mean, it makes it exceptionally tough because you want to play perfect and you want to get them to punt every single time, but it's not the way it works. And it's those big plays that you usually see that kill the defenses and break their backs. And you can hold them great, Reese, on first down, second down, it's third and long. You're in a perfect situation. You give up that one play for 80, and it changes the whole complexion of the game. So I think you got to have a little bit of both. It can't just be great defense the whole time. Usually the teams that play great defense can keep you in it, but only for so long. At some point, that offense has to get something going.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way if Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
Boy, I hope the second half's as good as the first. Just about set to start the third quarter in a tight one. Excellent kick. You think about film study coming up this week? They're not going to watch this. This has been sloppy football all the way around. Both teams turning it over. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clench up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Tackle made around the 28-yard line. From their own 28-yard line. Second down. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. And he's taken down at the 18. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Now he's going to run, and watch out.
Well, they didn't pick up the first down, but he saw that no one was open, so he made the right decision to tuck it and run.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Five wide. Caught, open field. He's tackled in the open field. gets it out to about the 50. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. He's at the 40. Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
You know, sometimes the defense just has a beat on an option, and there's no way the offense can gain positive yards on it.
Second and 13. Ball on the 37.
Ain't no such thing as a loss. We take a win home. 51's Mike. Mike,
go. Red two.
Brought down at the 34-yard line. He picked up around 3 yards on the draw play.
That brings up 30.
Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, and he shoved out of bounds right around the 28-yard line.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up fourth and five.
It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. Michigan State could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and he nails the long field goal. Like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Spartans continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
His receiver dropped it. Incomplete.
Number 80, the intended receiver on the play.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Trying to get it to the tight end, but it falls to the ground.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Grabs it and hammered right there. He really got a hold of that one. Oh, what a hit. The Broncos have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team's put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
We're set to get restarted as the offense looks to build on the success of their field goal on the last drive. Michigan State holds a field goal lead. Gains his way to the 49-yard line. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
Mike 51, Mike 51. Hey, let's calm down. Red, two, yellow, three.
Makes the grab past the marker. There was a 3-yard completion, and we'll have a first and 10 coming up.
Since he only needed a few yards, the little dump off pass worked to perfection.
When you've got a quarterback making throws that quickly, the defense doesn't have a lot of time to react to the play. Throws and it's incomplete.
Number 13 was the intended receiver on the way.
Second and 10. Ball on the 48.
51's Mike. Mike 51. Black Bonnet.
taken down around the 49-yard line.
When you're an option quarterback, you get used to getting caught pretty quickly. He'll bounce right back up.
He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. And he's taken down right around the 30. First and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. Around the 38-yard line.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
Roger, Roger! Mike 40, Mike 40!
That's three down and one to go. Michigan State's got a three-point lead. We're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter.
Four down. Let's go. Hey, Mike 40, Mike 40.
Ready, ride, 68, ride.
He tackles him for a loss.
The defense just met the blockers head on and drove them back straight into the runner.
Third down and 6 yards to go. Ball on the 35-yard line. Under pressure, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. Away, and it's a booming punt. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Michigan State is up a field goal. Got it, and brought down immediately. About 4 yards away here on second down. He fires right, pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds. It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line.
Mike 51. Here we go.
And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
Loss of 11 yards. That'll bring up third and long.
Hey,
kill, kill, kill. Black five, black five.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Wow, a long game, but still not enough for the first.
Well, the offense hurt themselves by digging themselves into a hole on first and second down, so the defense didn't really have to put too much thought in how to defend on that third down.
Fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit. Just over 2 minutes in the game. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and it's good. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. The Broncos have got to be fired up how this game is going. They still got a chance to win.
Well, you're talking about a huge underdog. It's battled the entire game. They've got the football here to start this drive late with a chance to take the lead. You can't even imagine what this would do for this football team if they can put 6 points up on the board.
Nice run, and he's brought down. He's scrambling, runs with it, and he's got room.
Boy, that is a huge first down. Not only did it pick up the first down, but it stops the clock and gives this offense a chance to regroup and get ready to maybe put the most important points on the board.
And he's sacked. Gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
To get back in this game here in the fourth, this third and goal is vital. Just over a minute left. Throws it deep. And he's got it. Touchdown. And we're all tied up. Try to tack on the extra point that will take the lead. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A five-play, 75-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The Spartans have played poorly all day long. That really doesn't matter right now.
They've played sloppy. They're not going to be happy when they go back and look at the film on Monday. But with all that being said, they still have a chance to win this game. And at the end of the day, that's all that matters, is trying to get that W.
Throws it in a hurry. And down he goes at the 42.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
Back five, back five, 3-15. Go.
Complete. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
Just might do it. Intercepted. steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
From their own 35-yard line, first down, Western Michigan. Up a point. Up the middle for a nice game. The Spartans will use their first time out of the half. Good outside run there.
Well, that's a great job by this offense. The defense knew that the run was coming, and they still could not slow them down. Pick up a first down and allows him to continue to work this clock.
He takes a knee. The Spartans, they're going to have to call their third and final timeout from their own 47-yard line. Second down. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. We had a fight to the finish here today. 17-16, Broncos. 17-16. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports at Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.